the front leg. Now this is going to hit you directly on top of the heart, which is about a quarter of the way down the chest, and that's exactly where we want to do our compression. So with compression, we're going to start, and I'm going to go ahead on my feet pretty loudly, so if it's too loud, go, someone, go like this, tell me to quiet it down. So we're going to go into our compressions, we're going to do 30 compressions, and then we're going to open and extend the airway. We're going to pull the tongue past the canines. We're going to create an airtight seal. An airtight seal. And when I do that, we're going to go right around the snout. And this is also called mouth-to-snout resuscitation. So we're going to use our mouth, and we're going to go to the snout, and we're going to do two rescue breaths. Now, the rescue breaths, we want to make sure that we're not overventilating. If you have a dog like this, you're probably going to have a little bit more force with your breath. But if you have a tiny little toy poodle like that guy or that Yorkie back there, it's not going to be exactly the same kind of breath that you're going to be doing with rescue. So determine the size of the pet. And also with rescue breaths, what we want to do is make certain that we're not doing it too quickly to overventilate either. So you're going to give a rescue breath. You're going to look for the rise and fall of the chest. You're going to give it just going to get the second rescue breath. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do 30 compressions and exactly what I just showed you here. And then from there, I'm going to go into a little bit more real time. So I'm going to describe it as I'm doing it, and then after